Have you ever gone on the computer to diagnose an ailment?
Yes.
Really?
Yeah.
Do you do it a lot?
All the time.
What?
Yes.
All the time, they say. More than half of us do it, but at what cost to our health? Okay, be honest. When you get sick or when something starts to hurt a little bit, you call your doctor or do you go online? Some people take searching for medical stuff on the web to a new extreme.
Rapid heartbeat, sweating.
He had a rash and a fever.
High blood pressure, high cholesterol.
So many people are doing it so much.
You Google all these things, you check them out on the computer?
Yes.
Do you have them all?
No, I have none.
It's nearly epidemic.
Have you ever gone on the computer to diagnose an ailment?
Maybe.
A lot of us do it for peace of mind, but end up with information overload.
I had a parathyroid problem, and I thought I had cancer.
Makes you scared, because I know half the stuff they're saying isn't true.
It's called cyberchondria, and let me tell you, it's for real.
Have you ever gone on the computer to diagnose a medical problem?
No.
Yes, you have. Look at you. That's such a bad lying face.
No, I've never done that. I don't know what you're talking about.
Recent studies on the subject suggest 60% of us do. Elizabeth LaRue has studied cyberchondria at the University of Pittsburgh School of Nursing. She says there are all sorts of hot medical websites the uninformed ailer likes to search, but one reigns supreme.
Statistically, it shows that Google is the default search engine, and people type in basically the question that they have. Why does my stomach hurt?
I had a pain in my stomach, so I checked it out, and later I found out it was my gallbladder because I had to go to the hospital.
There you go. And while studies suggest women in their mid-40s on are the biggest surfers, more men these days are testing those waters.
Get out of town.
Yeah, it's easy. When you have an iPhone and smartphones, kind of like... If you're out of town, I travel a lot, so I don't know what I have, so I can go in here real quick.
Question is, are you getting good advice or scary suggestions?
Case in point, say you're feeling dizzy for a couple days. You type that into a couple different websites. What could you have? Well, trichinosis caused by roundworms or Ramsay-Hunt syndrome that paralyzes your face, maybe even the incurable Meniere's disease. And some of these pictures really freak you out.
I think it scares you more. You think, you start looking these things up and there's more and more things that you could possibly have.
The five most searched medical topics: shingles, gallbladder, gout, hemorrhoids, and lupus. LaRue reminds all medical website surfers to stay calm and discriminate.
So when you're using the internet to find health information, don't forget to look at that, the quality of the information that you're taking.
So the next time somebody asks if you do it?
No.
Never?
No.
Ever?
Oh, yeah, but...
It's okay. We do it, too.
I am on WebMD, every other website, constantly.
Yeah, I know. So is there a really good, trustworthy website for layman's medical help? Our expert says, there is. MedlinePlus.gov. That's the one you should be bookmarking. It's written all at a level we can understand. There are true reference resources you can check out. Go to our website, WTAE.com. We have all of this for you and so much more. I love that.
Now, you said you actually do this.
I do, yes, of course. Who doesn't besides you?
I don't.
I know.
I just wait till it's too late.
Mike goes, I go to WebMD. Take it away, weatherman.
Yeah, you caught me. WebMD. Yeah. Said I either had an allergy or I was pregnant, so I'm not sure which, but we'll find out soon.